My mom was stalked and raped. Not me, but my mom. This is in Phoenix back in the 90s. Guy kept coming around to my mom's apartment, but she was always working, so her roommates, assuming he was another friend, said to just call back or come back another day. This happened a few times, and all the while my mom was oblivious and no one mentioned this stranger stopping by until after the third time. When my mom found out, obviously she was on edge and told them if they saw him again, to tell him to F off. He came back some time later and it happened my mom was alone at the apartment that day. He must have been stalking her for months, because as soon as she opened the door, she still didn't know what he looked like at this point, he pulled a gun on her and proceeded to rape her. She says she had a nightmare a week or so before that was very similar to the ordeal. She attributes that to emotionally preparing her and saving her life during the incident. During the rape, she took account of as many details as possible. At some point he jumped from the window and ran, but she had enough info to go to the police and roommates, witnesses, that saw the guy prior. Within 48 hours he was in custody. Still don't know why he targeted, stalked my mom, but I respect the living shit out of her for keeping her composure through the ordeal and remaining observant. My girlfriend crazy ex stalked and raped her. An ex of mine had a psychotic ex. He would send her fucked up emails and voicemails. This was 2000 folks, and when one got really violent and threatening, she filed a police report, but nothing came of it, at least no charges filed. We got into a fight over something stupid over the phone one night. She wanted to hang out just the two of us, and I wanted to see my friends since I was going out of town and wouldn't see them again until Christmas. She didn't want to tag along and kept insisting that I ditch them and be with her. I got pissed and said something mean along the lines of I'd known these guys for half my life and I'd known her half a year. She hung up on me, I went out with my friends and she ran out of the house to blow off some steam. He was waiting. He jumped her, kicked the ever-loving shit out of her and then raped her while she was barely conscious. When I called her the next day when I was back in my apartment out of town and she didn't answer, I assumed she was still pissed at me. It wasn't until the next day that her kid sister called me and told me what happened. He was never charged, and by all accounts, he fucked off back to Greece. The pigs, on their report, all but blamed her for it happening by dressing provocatively, which is to say, wearing a Fugazi t-shirt and red pants with a bunch of dummy zippers on them. Broken orbital bone, broken jaw, cracked rib, torn labia, but she didn't help herself dressing that way. Fuck right off. Listener stalked a radio DJ. I'm a radio host. A listener has been stalking and harassing me for over a year. Tried to break into my apartment in the middle of the day while I was home. I now have a restraining order against him, but he keeps trying to see me, so his new method is by filing all kinds of court orders against me just so I'll have to show up to court and he'll see me. He is now being charged with multiple harassment, fraud charges. I live in constant fear, I am always on edge and I'm genuinely considering leaving my job and the industry because of this never-ending nightmare. Childish creepy stalker. I am sure my story is not as intense as some, but here it goes. When I was around 15, I started finding bras, not mine, or even remotely my size, thrown places I would hang out, and in my yard, all of these bras had my name written on them in the same handwriting. They also usually included some derogatory statements indicating that I like certain sexual things, certain types of partners. My name would be written on a bridge by the river in our small town where all the kids my age would hang out. Basically, childish types of things. Eventually, it progressed to my house being broken into a couple of times. Fast forward to age 19, I am engaged and everything has been quiet for a while, then pornographic photos start showing up at my workplace, on my windshield, on my fiancé's windshield, all with the caption, before she was, my soon-to-be married name. Police reports were made but nothing ever came of it. The last incident was about 4 years ago. Someone, assuming it is the same person, tried to cut the brake lines on my truck. Luckily for me and my two small children, this individual was too dense to know ABS sensor wiring from brake lines. I am assuming this person is either in jail or has relocated since things have been quiet for a while now. Ex-high school boyfriend stalked me. My senior year of high school, my boyfriend, at the time, would show up to my job unannounced and say things like "the thought of not seeing you today is killing me," and then after we broke up he would call me at home and work constantly. Sometimes he would be outside my job when I got off begging to talk to me. All of this just made me scared. Finally, he called me late one night and told me that if I didn't take him back he'd kill himself. So I told my mother about everything. She called and spoke to him and then his mother, and he left me alone. Stockton College. In college I had a whiteboard outside of my dorm room. Someone began leaving messages like, "You are the most beautiful person I have ever seen." I'm a dude, so I wasn't used to hearing things like that, but at first it was kind of flattering. Soon whiteboard messages were joined by phone calls and voicemail messages. The person would never speak, but I would hear opera music in the background while someone cried into the phone. Now that was kind of creepy. Eventually it stopped, but shortly thereafter my room was broken into by someone wearing a ghost face costume from the movie Scream. My roommate woke up and saw this costumed weirdo standing over me with a plastic knife. He jumped out of bed and drop-kicked the guy across the room. The guy ran fast enough that we couldn't determine where he went, but it was likely into one of the neighboring dorm rooms. Otherwise we would have seen him running further down the hall to leave the building. My roommate and I were freaked out but basically laughed it off after we reported the incident to the resident advisor. We did find my PlayStation removed from its spot by the TV and placed on a shelf near the exit, so robbery might have been the motive and the timing between the break-in and the weird calls may have been a coincidence. Either way, the calls stopped and we never saw the Scream robber again. My roommate was huge, so that may have been the factor that scared him away. Creepy next door neighbor. I am still dealing with one. He's my next door neighbor who asked me out and then proceeded to harass me about wanting a girlfriend by messages, so I told him I wasn't interested. He left notes on my car, would ring my doorbell a million times when he knows I'm home alone, accost me in the parking lot. It accumulated in him waiting naked in my parking spot one day when I got home from work. Safe to say I now have a restraining order. My lease ends in December and then I'll move. Well, I parked somewhere else and tried not to look at him while I'm pretty sure he was touching himself. Then called a man in the complex to come and persuade him to get dressed and escort me into my house. Strip club customer stalked me. There was a stalker I had that I didn't know about until they tried following me home. I was a stripper for 5 years and I was going home one night, and this car rear-ended me. I got out, annoyed, realized it was the guy from the club I worked at, which was 10 miles away, so he was definitely following me and that was not a coincidence. But he was drunk and had his hands in his pockets, weapon, so I got back in the car and called 911, pretending that I was calling insurance because he was right in front of me trying to flirt with something in his pocket that I could not figure out. Cheers to the operators because they took the role of State Farm pretty seriously and seemed to understand I wasn't able to mention anything at the time. A policeman showed up not 2 minutes later and it turns out the guy was an illegal alien, driving drunk, had weed and LSD in the car, and a handgun in his pocket. I drove away terrified. I'm being stalked by two stalkers. My boyfriend's ex is stalking me on Instagram. And my ex is stalking me in real life. He shows up at my workplace and I'm a baker. So like I see his car parked outside my work at 2 a.m. I told him that I would call the police if he tries anything because he was pretty abusive in our relationship. He's not doing anything illegal, so I am helpless for now, and my former best friend's new boyfriend stalked my Instagram and several other social media accounts. Anonymously insulting me for 2 weeks. Like I got like 50 messages a day with just rude comments and stuff. Threatened to report them to the police for I know who it was and even had proof. They got scared and stopped immediately. My mom ex-boyfriend stalked us. My mother dated a man who turned out to be abusive. Once she ended this, he began to stalk us. In the beginning I didn't have a license. Later on, when I did, he started stalking both of us. Some clues we found were seeing odd cars driving slowly in the neighborhood. This isn't a sign by itself, but when combined with the same cars being seen nearby at other times, we figured it out. He knew people who owned new and used car dealerships. We started hearing from friends about things we had done that no one would really know about. Like my mom may have visited a relative or I went to a party with friends. Somehow a neighbor or other person asked how that was. We found out he was talking to these people as friends without them knowing what he was up to. So they were volunteering information in a harmless way. Our trash started being disturbed. Found out he was going through it and taking out things like billing statements, letters, and so on. This was before privacy and identity theft were an issue. In the single worst example, he had shown a letter I had written to a prospective girlfriend to a friend of his. I threw out my drafts and accidentally left it there. I just happened to see it when I was there, and the mutual friend told me that she thought the guy had it to proofread it for me. Humiliating. I noticed once I had my license I was being followed when I was out on country roads and so on. Even through college he did it on occasion when people in my hometown knew when I had gone dancing or whatever at clubs. So, all in all, just be vigilant. If you ever feel someone is following you, be it a stalker or a road rage person, do not go home. Go to a well-lit area or a manned police station. Shred everything you throw away if there's anything personal on it. Get a good cross-cut shredder that cuts into a tiny pieces. And these days, call the police. They'll take it more seriously than they did in the past.